Tammy Kolda, an applied mathematician, and this is Unlocking LaTeX Graphics. Today we're going to talk about making legends horizontal so that all the entries are side by side. By default, legends are vertical with entries stacked. I'll show you how to make the legend horizontal, put it where you want it to be, and a few tweaks to make it look nice. I have many more videos on TikZ and PGFPLOTS, which I urge you to check out. These videos are based on my book, Unlocking LaTeX Graphics, as well as some bonus materials. I've already created the preamble for our document today. I'm including parskip and full page just to make things look nice, and hyperref is so that I can link the author name back to the YouTube channel. We'll be working with plots and legends, so I'm including, of course, the PGFPLOTS package. Whenever we use the PGFPLOTS package, I recommend to set some recommended defaults. In particular, it's a good idea to specify the compatibility, which I'm setting here to 1.17. I also recommend specifying scale only axis. The remainder of the settings are specific to today's episode. I'm setting the default width and height to be 8 cm by 5 cm. I'm creating 4 plot styles to make things simpler. I show the data that we'll be plotting today in a box at the bottom of the screen. Each style specifies the table column that should be plotted. For instance, the style named A will use the column labeled A for its Y values. By default, the first column are the X values. Each style also specifies its color and its mark. I'll paste here the plot we'll be working with today. I'm plotting 4 columns from data.txt using the plot styles that we defined above, A, B, C, and D. Most importantly for today's episode, this plot has a legend because I specify the legend entries in the axis options. By default, the legend is placed in the northeast corner of the plot. There are 5 predefined positions for placing a legend accessible via the legend position key. These are northwest, northeast, southwest, southeast, and outer northeast. I just pasted code to move the legend to the outer northeast. When we compile that, we see that the legend has moved as specified. But what if we want something other than those 5 positions? We're going to need that to do our horizontal legend and put it in a reasonable place. For this, we specify some settings via the legend style key. The legend style key appends the every axis legend style. We specify how to position the legend using the at key and the anchor key inside legend style. I'm going to paste this here and get rid of this legend position key because it will actually be overwritten in any case when we change things. The coordinate system that the at key references places 0, 0 in the lower left and 1, 1 in the upper right corner. Setting it to 0.5, 1.03 places the legend point horizontally in the middle and just above the top axis. We also have to specify the anchor point, and that says what part of the legend is attached to this at point we just specified. So now we have our legend at the top in the middle. Now that we have the legend where we want it, let's make it horizontal. This is done by adding the legend columns key and setting it equal to -1. Once I compile that, the legend is horizontal just as we had wished. I just might make 1 or 2 tweaks to make it look better. The way that the legend is rendered means that there is no extra space following each legend entry. To fix that, we can manually change the legend entries by adding tildes for hard-coded spaces. I like 3 spaces after each entry, except the last, which doesn't need any extra space. When I add that and recompile, now we see that there's some extra space between the text and then the next legend entry. Finally, one last tweak I'll make is that I'll say draw equals none in the legend style to remove the outline of the legend box, which I don't think we really need when it's horizontal and above like that. And I think that looks a lot nicer. I hope you found today's episode on horizontal legends helpful. If you did, please click like or subscribe. If you have TikZ or PGFPLOTS questions, please post them in the comments. If you want to learn more, please check out the other videos. I also have a book, Unlocking LaTeX Graphics, available for purchase at major book retailers. Thanks for watching.